Now, this is our second lecture on flexibility and stiffness method. So let's first consider a flexibility method. This flexibility method is also called force method or compatibility method. Why we call force method? Because we considered forces as unknowns. That is, the support reactions we considered as unknowns. Force may be a reaction or a moment. That's why the method is called force method. And compatibility means we are going to use compatibility equations, compatibility conditions at the supports in order to find out these unknown forces. That's why this method is also called compatibility method. So flexibility method or force method or compatibility method. Then let's consider one example. So let us develop a procedure for solving the problem by using flexibility. Only procedure we will see. We are not going to solve this problem, but we want to establish a systematic procedure to solve the problem by using flexibility method. Say fixed beam. Let's consider a fixed beam subjected to any type of external loading. So whenever a beam is fixed and loading is only vertically downward, then static degree of indeterminacy, we know number of reactions minus available equilibrium conditions. We have four reactions, total four reactions here. That is Ra, Rb, Ma, Mb. So four reactive forces minus two equilibrium conditions, that is summation Fi equal to zero and summation M equal to zero. Here we have not considered horizontal reaction at the supports. That means summation Fx equal to zero is neglected. So that means the degree of indeterminacy is two. So any two reactions we can consider as unknowns. So it is better to consider reactions at one support as unknowns here. Select Q1 equal to Rb and Q2 equal to Mb be the unknown. So slightly different notations we have to use because these are the matrix methods. So I am going to use unknown forces as Q1, Q2. So Rb equal to Q1 and Mb equal to Q2. So the coordinates we have to assign. So this is assigned coordinates in the direction of unknown. So Q1 and Q2 in the direction of Rb and Mb. Or simply we can say coordinate 1, coordinate 2. That also okay. Now what we have to do, so remove the constraints offered by the corresponding to the selected unknowns and obtain the statically determined structure. So that means remove Rb and Mb. So make the end B as a free end, so it will be a cantilever B. So this is fixed, this is free end now. The structure is called statically determinate, or we can say released structure. So obtain a released structure by releasing the constraints offered by that support. So that is allowed vertical deflection as well as slew. Now, due to external loading, what you do? Due to external loading, first find out the displacements corresponding to the selected unknowns. Now this is a cantilever beam subjected to vertically downward load. It will deflect like this. The vertical deflection here, that is in the direction of Q1, and displacement in the direction of Q2 is a rotation. So how the rotations are taken? DQ1L represents first letter displacement in the direction of Q1 due to loading. Here displacement in the direction of Q2 due to loading. So DQ1L is the displacement in the direction of Q1 due to loading. DQ2L is the displacement in the direction of Q2 due to loading. So this we have to calculate now for the given external loading. So next, what we have to do after getting these displacements, let's apply unit actions one by one in the direction of unknowns and find out corresponding displacements. And these displacements represent flexibility coefficients. That means these two steps, nothing but finding out flexibility coefficients. So apply a unit load, upward unit load, in the direction of Rb. Since Rb is upward, so load is applied is upward. And now find out flexibility coefficient F11 and F21. these flexibility coefficients, in order to get the final displacements due to RB, we have to multiply it by Q1, or due to Q1, we have to multiply it by these coefficients, by Q1, so that the final displacements in the direction of unknowns we will get by Q1. Now then Q2 means first calculate the coefficients. So apply a unit moment in the direction of Q2. Q2 here assumed is clockwise, apply clockwise unit moment and find out the displacements corresponding to the coordinates, assumed coordinates or corresponding to the unknowns. And these displacements are to be multiplied by Q2. So to get the final displacements due to the Q2. Now, see what we have to do. Next, we have to use the compatibility conditions. Because in the original structure, there is no vertical deflection at B. There is no rotation at B since the support B is fixed. So therefore, next what we will do using compatibility conditions. So where these conditions are to be used? In the direction of unknowns only. Using compatibility conditions. That is, what is the first condition? Delta B must be 0 and theta B must be 0. So these two are the compatibility conditions. Delta B must be 0 and theta B must be equal to 0. So that means the first condition is dQ1L displacement due to loading plus F11Q1 displacement due to Q1 in the direction of first chord Q1, then displacement due to Q2 in the direction of Q1, that is plus minus etc. That we will after calculations we will consider that. So F12 Q2 equal to 0. So this is the first equation. Second, by using this theta B equal to 0, so this is dQ2L plus F21Q1 plus F22Q2 is equal to 0. So two equations we will get in terms of Q1 and Q2. So now our aim is to find out Q1 and Q2, that is vertical reaction at B and bending moment at B. So that means this we can write down in matrix form. So in matrix form means we have to solve these two equations, that's all. Two equations, two unknowns. So dQ2L plus the F11, F12, F21, F22, and this is Q1, Q2 is equal to, this is 0, 0. So this is in matrix form. Or in symbolic form, I will write down, this is dQL plus this is flexibility coefficient matrix, this is unknown force vector equal to 0. So for single vertical column use vector notation. So this is vector notation, and for rows use matrix notation. So if only single column is there, then vector is to be used. So then here, what is unknown? This is unknown. So that means F into Q equal to, we can take this as say dQL minus. Then this Q is equal to F inverse into dQL. So this gives us unknowns, and this number of simultaneous equations may be equal to the number of unknowns, and number of unknowns may be equal to the static degree of indeterminacy. So by using this procedure, we can solve the problems of this. Now say how to write down the step-by-step procedure for solving the problem. Say steps, let's write down the steps. First step, find static degree of indeterminacy. Find static degree of indeterminacy and select unknowns. Select unknowns. That is, say Q1, Q2, Q3, and so on. So number of unknowns. Number of the selected unknowns must be equal to static degree of indeterminacy. How many unknowns? The static degree of indeterminacy. Then second step, obtain released structure, obtain released structure or statically determinate by removing unknowns. So let's obtain a statically determinate and find displacements corresponding to unknowns due to external loading. So which this that is dq1l, dq2l, dq3l, and so on. So the displacement in the direction of Q1 due to loading, displacement in the direction of second unknown due to loading, third unknown due to loading. Then third step, find flexibility coefficients. Flexibility coefficients such as F11, F12, F21, F22, etc. Flexibility coefficients by applying unit actions 1 by 1 in the direction of unknowns. So you will get the flexibility coefficients in the direction of unknowns. Then fourth step. So select unknowns, obtain released structure, statically determinate, find out displacements due to external loading in the direction of unknowns, then find out flexibility coefficients in the direction of unknowns due to unit actions applied 1 by 1. And the next step is find unknowns by using compatibility conditions by using compatibility conditions. That is, DQ1L plus F1121 plus F12Q2 plus F13Q3 plus and so on equal to 0. The second condition, equation D21L plus F21Q1 plus F22Q2 plus F23Q3 plus so on equal to 0. Then, so such number of equations we can form, say equal to the say I may write here D U N L plus F N N we need a number, particular number. So flexibility quotient, suppose it is of N, number of unknowns are N, then coordinates are also N. So FNNQ1, FNNQ2, no, this will be FN1Q1 plus FN2Q2 plus FNNQN equal to 0. So such equations, number of equations equal to number of unknowns we will get. And now, next, we can write down all these equations in matrix form. So in matrix and in symbolic form, finally, DQL plus flexibility coefficient matrix, this unknown vector equal to 0. So such symbolic form of equation we will get. Now suppose if DQ is equal to original displacements in the direction of unknowns. Suppose some sinking of support is given, yielding of support is given in the direction of unknown, then instead of 0, what we will get is DQL plus F into Q equal to TQ. So this will get. That means F into Q is equal to DQ minus DQL. And we may write FQ equal to resultant displacement. So this is resultant displacement. So that means the unknown forces equal to F inverse into D. This is a vector, it should be vector, it's D. So this way we can calculate the unknown forces. Then fifth step, the remaining support reactions should be calculated by using equilibrium conditions, and after getting this, now the next last step is draw SFD and BMD, because our ultimate aim is to design the structure. And unless we complete SFD BMD, the design is not possible. In order to design, we should know the design forces, that is shear forces, bending moments, etc. So this is the overall procedure to solve the problems by using flexibility method. What is left is only solving problems. So now by using flexibility method, so we will solve some simple problems in the beginning. So as compared to flexibility method, stiffness method is more easy, because in flexibility method, calculation of displacements is difficult, slightly tough, involves more calculations, so we have to use some other method to calculate the displacements. Now let's consider a propped cantilever beam. So problem is, analyze a propped cantilever beam subjected to loading as shown in figure. So I am considering propped cantilever beam. Say here there is a support, prop support, may be hinge or may be roller, whatever it is, subjected to uniformly distributed load W. Per meter run, L is the span, this is A, this is B. Very simple problem, propped cantilever beam. So one end is fixed, other is supported on prop. So what is static degree of indeterminacy? Static degree, say here there will be a vertical reaction, remember, and here there will be vertical reaction, there will be a moment. So RA, MA, and this is RB. Say only three reactions, no horizontal load, no horizontal reaction. That means only two equations we can consider. So 3 minus 2, 1. Or this is fixed end. If we consider three reactions, this is 1, 4 reactions minus 3 standard equilibrium equations, again you will get 1. So static degree of indeterminacy is 1. Let select any one reaction as unknown. Say this RB, let's take RB as unknown. Any one reaction, because only one degree of indeterminacy, static degree of indeterminacy. So that means only one reaction is to be selected as unknown. So only one equation will be developed. So problem is very easy. Now what is the next step as per our procedure? Is obtain statically determined structure by removing the reaction RB. So now RB is removed. RB is removed. This is W per meter run. So RB is now removed. Now this will deflect like this. And this vertical deflection that we have to calculate, this is displacement in the direction of loading, in the direction of unknown Q1 due to loading. So this is, now what is this? WL4, the free end deflection is WL4 upon ATI. This is WL4 divided by ATI. Again, remember the RB is upward, this is downward, therefore minus. That same convention we will write later on somewhere. Now the RB assumed reaction, unknown reaction is upward, Q1 is upward, and this occurs downward, therefore negative. Next, remove RB, remove external load, apply unit action in the direction of RB, and this will cause upward deflection, because we have only one unknown, there is no need to find out rotation, only deflection is to be calculated. And this is upward deflection, this is upward, so F11 is that PL cube, L cube upon 3i. So this load is 1, so WL cube by 3i, W is 1, so it is L cube by 3i. This coefficient is to be multiplied by unknown, that is Q1. This coefficient is to be multiplied by unknown Q1. Now next, using compatibility condition. Next is using compatibility condition, that is delta B equal to 0. So Q1L plus F11Q1 must be equal to 0. So compatibility condition, delta B equal to 0, that means this plus this must be 0, that's all. So this is equal to this plus this must be equal to 0. So let's substitute. This is minus WL fourth by ATI, and this is plus F11 L cube by 3EI into Q1. So this is equal to 0. So you solve this and find out Q1. So you will get this 3WL by 8 and positive upward, and this is nothing but your reaction RB. So Q1 is nothing but RB. Solving this, so because this L cube, this will get cancelled, EI get cancelled, this is 3WL by 8. Now to find RA, see what is the next step after getting these unknowns. Then by using equilibrium condition, remaining reactions means RA and MA we have to calculate. To find RA, use summation FY equal to 0. So RA plus RB equal to total downward load. So RA equal to WL minus RB, 3WL by 8. So this is 5WL by 8. So this is also positive, means this will act upward. Then summation M about A equal to 0. Summation M about A equal to 0. Now here, while taking the moments, either take clockwise positive, anticlockwise negative. So suppose if you now see with this assumed direction, if you write summation M equal to 0 and your answer is positive, then the assumed direction is also okay. Now I have assumed this as anticlockwise. Let's take all anticlockwise positive, clockwise negative. So this is say MA is anticlockwise due to reaction, that is plus RB into L anticlockwise, and due to loading minus WL square by 2 equal to 0. Now substitute for RB. RB is, so MA is equal to WL square by 2 minus RB is 3WL square upon 8. So this is equal to, so LCM you can take as 8 and 4 minus 3WL square by 8. So anticlockwise. So this, now you can write down, now we have analyzed the beam completely. This is WL square by 8. This is 5WL by 8. And this comes out to be 3WL by 8. Now with this, let's draw BMD. So you can draw BMD, SFD both. So little bit fast we will take. Say shear force diagram, this is for you, and then this is 3. So this is 3WL by 8, 5WL by 8, this is plus, this is minus SFD. And then for BMD, we can use method of superimposition or direct we can plot. This is, we know WL square by 8 for simply support 8, and this is also WL square by 8 and a moment, say WL square by 8, this is negative, this is positive, right? So by shaded area we can show the resultant BMD. So this is called point of contraflexure. Or in other way also you can draw the BMD, that you have the practice of plotting SFD, BMD, etc. The same diagram you can show here, this is point of contraflexure. Say this way you will get, so this is positive, this is negative. So this is also the BMD we can draw in other way. This is point of contraflexure. Both meaning is same. The ordinates of both the diagrams are same. But this is drawn by method of superimposition. And this is the direct way.